Well, there is like an itchy thing I have as a journalist that I have the feeling we still don't know the whole truth. Not about Armstrong, not about Verbrugge.
What do you don't know now?
What do you want to know? He's going to give the answers.
Oh. I think almost everything is out. Yeah, we don't know exactly how many units of EPO, how many blood bags and stuff like that. But
no, I'm talking about the cooperation between Armstrong and the UCI. UCI has a new president now. There was a lot to do about that. The former guy had to go. Now he's a guy saying, well, transparency, cleaning up the whole mess. But we still don't know what did Armstrong and Verbrugge do together. Did he really help him?
Where was the money? Of course he helped him.
Yeah, you know, but
now we know.
He was like after 99, all the we had the big problems in 98. I start cycling, maybe also a reason. But with the Festina affair, and in 99, Armstrong came back from cancer and he went immediately to Tour de France. Everybody wants to have a guy like that in the peloton.
It was a gift. Yeah,
it's the most easy. And for sure, like the small things like cortisone at that time, it was like peanuts. It was nothing. Yeah. And if you can make a cream and the EPO test, like in the Tour of Swiss, it all happened.
Yeah.
So, yeah, for sure he helped. But I think Verbrugge is not sleeping one night less now. He's just... I know the guy a little bit and... he's pretty confident and he's sitting at home. Maybe sometimes he's watching his bank account and he's just
He doesn't have seven yellow jerseys on the wall.
I met him last year in Tour of Beijing and we were walking out of the hotel because I have to catch a flight to go back home. And all the news from Armstrong came out that week and I say, Hein, it's going to be pretty busy for you. No, Thomas. And he showed me a Chinese girl. She's going to guide me this week in Beijing. It's a beautiful city. And I think, yeah, it's typical about Hein.
Yeah, that's
don't give a fuck.